We're very grateful. We know a lot of you have travelled a long way, and the reason this is a one-off is because the English tour is actually in November, and all the wonderful people from the Whistle Test, now because they've cancelled Robin's Nest and a few other programmes, they've got to have something to slot in that's cheap. So they picked on us, because we're pretty cheap for those of you who've been before. So what we're going to do tonight, because the reason there's no support is because we don't know what they're going to use for the programme, which comes out in October, so you can watch it then, because you don't believe what goes on tonight. And don't laugh. So what we're going to do, for those of you who have weak bladder temperament, I will in fact tell you what we're playing beforehand, because some of you might need to go out during the numbers, because we're going to play for quite a long time. All the arrangements are new. For those of you who've seen us before, bloody death, we're going to do bits and odds and sods of everything. This is an arrangement. We've got a few surprises. In fact, the old Dirtex there was a bit of a surprise. I mean, the miniskirts didn't arrive in time. That's the next best thing. This is an arrangement from the Arthur album.
Thank you.
very much. Shot already, we've already started. Thanks a lot. We're going to, as I said, we're going to do mixes from all albums. I think for anybody who saw us last year, there's one album that I said that I wasn't overwhelmingly happy with. That was the Rhapsodies album. In fact, I hated it, but I tried hard. But there was one, there was a couple of tracks that were half decent on it. And one of the ones that's half decent. Yeah, that's half decent. Thank you for what I said, dear boy. Thanks, Mum. This is Seahorses. Thanks very much. As I say, for those of you who may have been before, we've changed the band around a bit. Some of you might... Actually, that isn't Ashley Holt. He hasn't... unless he's had the change, and from where I'm standing, he obviously hasn't. This is Corrie. And as you... Because... Now, we felt that we were getting a little bit too butch, you know. Well, he was anyway. So we thought, we always like to try and help people out. We thought that he needed a bit of helping out because he was, a little bit. Well, not a lot. Well, quite a lot, actually. So we thought if we got Corrie in, it might help him out. Hasn't done an awful lot. This is, for those of you who bought the album and those of you who are even brave enough to have bought the single, you'll have noticed that there's two different singers. I won't bother to go into the politics as why those two different singers, but if you've already bought the album, then you should, because we're very poor, go out and buy the single. And this is Julia from 1984.
We threw off our chains.
actually doing a lot of things we've never done before. Because, believe it or not, say we don't, we do listen to what you horrible lot tell us sometimes. And on the last tour, we made a list of things that you asked us to play. And in fact, you know, for example, we'd be in Newcastle and people would ask us to play somewhere else. You know, things like that. We kept a careful note, actually, of a lot of the things that that we'd never played before. And a lot of them came from, believe it or not, right back to the first album, from the Henry album, because never on stage before we ever played Catherine of Aragon or Anne of Cleves. And we're not going to. No, actually, what we did, we thought, that'll be a doddle, so we got into rehearsal. It took us 5 days to get this piece off, because it was... So, bear with us. This is the first time we've done it. This is a conglomeration of Catherine of Aragon and Anne of Cleves.
Thank you.
The only person we're missing tonight, out of those who said they could come, unfortunately, is Tim Rice. Literally, it's 4:30, he called up to say that, well, he's stuck somewhere, but he sends his deep apologies, and we've got the next best thing in. We've also got, which I'd like to welcome, officially, we didn't know what to call them, you know, because, I mean, you couldn't really call them the Lilettes or something, so we called them the Dirtettes. Here they are. Give them a go on. It's Vicky, Sonia and Stevie. And for this, now Auntie Corrie joins us, so we've got 4 Dirtettes, which is very useful because there's 4 of us in the band. But there's, well, 3 and him. Also, he's not quite here yet, but he should be here any minute now. We had his brother, we call him Boghead, by the way, because his hair's like a lavatory brush. And he's got a brother called Boghead Senior. There's lots of Bogheads, they're everywhere. And Boghead Senior played the sax on the album, and he's very kind to come along. So, big ripple for Boghead Senior. Hey, come on, Boghead. Look at him. Oh, dear. That's enough, thank you, all right. They want paying if we keep carrying on with this. So for the next 4.5 minutes, this is The Proles.
Oh.
He's a bit fatter than Tim Rice, but the voice is the same. I'm going to do a few odds and pieces from... I nearly said sods, but my mum's here. Oh, I said it, didn't I? That's cost me, I've got a pound now. We're going to do a few little mixtures from the Journey album. Which you may or may not recognise.
Thank you. From a far gone time, no living man has seen.